Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Bala Yopi Jadano Grahat Tare Nana Mata Graham Vyapta Siddhanta Sagaram Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, in the way of pure devotion, there cannot be any compromise. Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, in the way of pure devotion, perfect devotion, there cannot be any compromise. We cannot go for any compromise with anybody. This is not at all allowed. If you allow compromise, in that case surely you are not doing pure devotion. You are not in favor of pure devotion. Actually, compromise means you will have to leave some good and you will have to accept some bad from somebody with whom you are going to make some compromise. So it's sure that if you are going to do some compromise, then surely you are going to accept some bad from somebody which is not perfect, and you are going to lose something. This way, ultimately you can get deviated from the pure devotional track. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Path Padma can ultimately throw you away from pure devotional field, track. It's not a matter of joke. Pure devotion is not a matter of joke. I was discussing that point in that mode that day. Guru Vaishnava having that kind of power, that kind of ability, that kind of tremendous power, that they can catch all Jivatma. Yes, Krishna actually, Krishna attracting Guru Vaishnava also have attraction. Because they have pure devotion, and out of pure devotion they confine Supreme Lord inside their heart. That's why anybody coming in front of Guru Vaishnava, they feel satisfaction. Any Jivatma, of course those who are having some demonic character, some aparadh, I'm not speaking about that. All ordinary people, maybe they have done so many papa, that's not a matter. Because knowingly, unknowingly, everybody doing some papa. Knowingly or unknowingly, everybody doing some papa. So actually, aparadh is dangerous. See, if somebody not doing any aparadh, if anybody in this material world, he is coming in front of Guru Vaishnava, he feels some sort of satisfaction, consolation. Suppose with heavy heart, he is coming with heavy heart in front of Guru Vaishnava to express his heavy heart, to make him light, you know. Like, you know, Chitraketu Raja was with heavy heart because son gone. That time Naraji Maharaj and that Muni came, another Muni, they came to give consolation to him, and ultimately he was really in a position to cut all his, you know, grievance, all his, you know, pain. The only way open before us is to come in front of pure Guru Vaishnava. If any kind of grievance, any kind of dissatisfaction there, any kind of pain there, heavy hurt, only and only you will have to come in front of Guru Vaishnava. Not, you cannot expect anything from any bonded soul. This is the main tragedy. One bonded soul going to depend upon another bonded soul. They are going to exchange view. They are going to exchange love. And the result ultimately, both of them going to hell. Big problem. not possible. Actually, in Rasamrita Sindhu, we find one nice word. What that word is? Very nice word. Prinanam sarvajagatam. Prinanam sarvajagatam. Prinanam sarvajagatam means that Guru Vaishnava can give hospitality, give satisfaction to everybody. Suppose some guest coming to your house, you are arranging him, you are going to arrange his nice staying with nice prasadam, nice sleeping, nice resting, not going to give any pain to his heart so that he can feel disturbed. This way, everybody going to take care of guest. Because as per Hindu Shastra, it is written that guest is Narayan. Atithi, Sarup is Narayan Sarup. Suppose you are going to take prasadam. In the meantime, some guest coming. You will have to stop your eating. You cannot take. It is not uchishta as yet. You will have to give this prasadam to that guest. You will have to go fasting. This is the procedure. Guru Padmadmurli also used to do in his temple Kalna. Many times it happens so. So now, if you are going to Gorkishadva Babaji in front of Gorkishadva Babaji Maharaj, in front of Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, what you can expect from them? They cannot allow your staying. They have no place, Gorkishadva Babaji Maharaj. They have no place to stay. So they cannot allow you. They cannot allow you nice, nice, sweet paramanna, this, that, prasadam. But still, if you approach a pure Guru Vaishnava, Bhaktisiddhanta Bhavaji Maharaj Adi, I don't know why, some sort of unknown satisfaction coming and touching your heart. I don't know what kind of satisfaction you are getting. It's unknown satisfaction. You cannot explain it. Going to touch your heart, you are going to get consolation rightly. Many times it happens so, in front of Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, somebody coming, in front of Gorkishwar Babaji Maharaj, in front of Vamsidas Babaji Maharaj. I already told, I think, one mother crying heavily with one small son in lap and coming in front of Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj and is crying. Babaji Maharaj said, why you are crying, mother? Baba Maharaj, I have no other way. I am going to give this my son unto your lotus feet. If you can save, then it's okay. If you cannot save, if you are not going to save, then I say, by no means, no way I can give him protection. What happens? But it is, today is that special day when one snake can cut this baby, I mean the boy. In his horoscope it is there. 100% today, snake can come and cut him. Like Parikshit Maharaj, you know, snake surely within 7 days, snake can come and bites. Parikshit Maharaj going to leave body. But going to leave body, okay. But within that period, going to leave body, but within that period, it is, you know, within that period, going to leave body, but within that period, Parikshit Maharaj going to leave body, okay, no problem. You also going to leave body. I am also going to leave body. Everyone, who not? This material world, na? Martha Jagat, it is called in Sanskrit, Martha Jagat, material Jagat. So here, everybody going to die. Who is going to leave? Along with, there is some specific period. It is already calculated in your life. So up to that period, you are going to live. Be careful all the time. You will have to cry in front of Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava. That is the only way you can make progress in your bhajan. There's no other way. Only and only you will have to cry whole day and night. I am helpless. I have no support. You will have to give me support. Hey Guru Vaishnava, only the way, only way, the only way. Now actually, Parikshit Maharaj is going to leave body. You already know. I am not going to explain it big way. Within 7 days, similarly, Parikshit Maharaj got the scope to hear Bhagavatam Katha, Sadhu Sanga, Satsanga. Satsanga, Satsanga, Sarva Shastra Koi, already I discussed many times, you know it very well. But what to what translation you can, your heart can make. But actually feeling is very rare. If you can make interpretation of this slok, that you can make. But from heart if you feel, then you can day and night you can cry to get continuous non-stop sadhu sangha. I don't like to live without sadhu sangha. I don't like to live without sadhu sangha. All the time I like to get sadhu sangha, because if I get sadhu sangha, in sadhu sangha there is continuous harikatha coming on. That day I was speaking, na? The source from where continuous aprakita sabda brahma emanating coming out is called Guru Vaishnava. So continuous scope, you have the scope to hear continuously, you have the scope to hear Harikatha from Guru Vaishnava. Satang prasangyad mimma virja sangvido bhavanti hritkarna rasayana katha tajyosanad asu apavarga vartmani. You know this sloka, Kapilji, huh? So sadhu sangha. Even those who are siddha, going up, nitya siddha and sadhana siddha, they are also crying to get sadhu sangha. They are nitya siddha, but still they are crying to get sadhu sangha, because when Supreme Lord wants to give benediction, Prabhu, you bless me so that I can get sadhu sangha, continuously I can get sadhu sangha. Any birth, according to my activities, karma fall, if I am going to take this bird, that bird, no problem, I am not going to give any objection. I have no objection, but please allow, so that each and every birth, I can get the scope to get sadhu sangha. Every birth, I like to get pasupakki hoye thaki sarge ba niroge, Tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinoda hidaye. So, satsanga, we want to get satsanga. Satsanga can give a full protection, 100% protection. That's why if Supreme Lord want to give some benediction, still they want, Prabhu, you give me blessing. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur continuously praying. Eternal parsada Gauranga Mahaprabhu, eternal parsada Radha Govinda Ji Leela, Kamal Manjari, continuously crying and speaking, Hey Prabhu, actually, I like to get satsanga. And not only that, Vaishnava Vishwas Vidhi Hau Khane Khane. Hey Prabhu, you can arrange in my life so that each and every fraction of second, I can grow my trust, belief in Guru Vaishnava. That is the vital point of bhajan. That is a mystery lying inside your bhajan path. There is a top secret thing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur teaching us, but we are so blind, we cannot realize it. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Kirtan, crying and speaking, Hey Prabhu, Vaishnava Vishas Vriddhi Ho Kshane Khane. Kshane Khane mean every fraction of a second, I like to increase my belief unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. You arrange this situation. No way, I am not going to misunderstand Guru Vaishnava anyway. So, this is the procedure through which we can go ahead. But the point I started with, I like to speak some specific point today, that I started with the sloka, you can remember. And also I touched this point, we should not go for any compromise in the way of pure devotional field. If any institution, any acharya, they are going to make some procedure easy, made easy, you know, those who are not reading whole year. At the time of exam, maybe 15 days or 20 days, 1 month before, they get one made easy from market and start reading. Suggestion and made easy to give answer. Actually, they have no thorough knowledge. They are actually lazy. They don't like to give appropriate time in their education, this and bhajan field. So how I can know that you are really interested in bhajan? How? What is the symptom? So that I can understand that you are really interested to hear, to do Hari Bhajan. What you have done for Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava? You have given your heart and body? No? We cannot give. Vāñca kalpa durvasya kipāsindu bevaja patitānang pāvana bhavishnava bhyo namo. We speak. Body, speech and mind. But actually, we are not dedicated soul. That's why we cannot start actual bhajan. That is the main procedure. So compromise is not at all possible. Radharani never go for compromise. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also never go for them. But somebody speaking, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, no. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never go for compromise. The only thing you can get, special thing, that is special karuna. Special karuna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to excuse you. This Dhamma, Navadip Dhamma, Nityananda Gauranga Mahaprabhu can give you 100 times excuse. Okay, let Prabhu excuse me, I have done something. Okay, go. Mercy, exclusive mercy, that you can. But you cannot show in the whole Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whole life I should not spare, so Leela. Life means ordinary. So whole life, whole Leela you cannot show one single instant when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to make any compromise with any body or any group. You cannot show. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not even those who are the actual follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to reject them. Maybe not internally, but externally. Why? Sri Shambhasan. Chato Haridas were rejected forever. Rejected. Mahaprabhu not going to say. So this way, Brahmananda Bharati also, I can go on discussing with Gaur Purnima approaching, outside devotees can come also in details, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to maintain too much perfection. So perfection, never going to make any compromise with anybody in pure devotional field, not at all. Mahaprabhu externally going to show us that I cannot excuse. Even if you are not going to do 1 lakh Harinam very, very gently, very nicely, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not going to take even water, fruits, anything from you. So anyway, you will have to arrange time so that you can, oh, you Maharaj, I become tired. No tiredness can come, I promise you. You go on doing Harinam and Kirtan, you can feel somewhere from some power coming. I promise you, you can try. Right from the 2:30 or 3, at least 3 o'clock you do, or if not 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock you try. Try to do and see, check up, I am speaking right or wrong. If you go on doing Harinam, that is called actual rest. You are making mistake. You think if you go to bed, then you can feel rest. Actual rest means you are going to do Harinam. It is not my Siddhanta, it is the Siddhanta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is the Siddhanta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Swarup Gosai Rai Ramanda going to take leave from Gambhira Mandir, Prabhu, today is almost approaching midnight, we are going, Govinda become very angry. You take rest, Prabhu. Prabhu crying and speaking, what do you mean by rest? If you are speaking Harikatha and Kirtan, I am getting rest. When you go away, what condition I meet, I don't know. I cannot calculate what condition I meet. They know, they cannot control me. I go outside, I'm crying and, you know, I like to go out, I'm going to die. This kind of situation is created. When you are speaking Harikatha Kirtan, I'm getting rest. So really so, big Guru Vaishnava, Gaurakishwar Babaji Maharaj, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupad, Bhakti Puri Goswami, you can go through their life history, you can say, Sridhar Maharaj, they are getting rest through Harinam and Kirtan. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj never feel tired. What kind of vitamin minerals Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj is taking? You can go, you can start crying, you can burst into tears to watch the life history of Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj. If you are man, human being, you cannot stay. You can start crying. Like beggar. No resting, nothing. only dry bread, something, and oh, getting enjoyment in kirtan, playing midanga whole day. When Swami Maharaj gone, in Vrindavan, there also, they make big procession, and Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, whole road, full way, my god brother gone, crying and doing kirtan. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj specially, special midanga, he has one special group, he go on doing kirtan. Whole life. No prasadam, no nothing, no water, no rest, nothing. But we always want to get some opportunity to get rest. But that resting is not actually rest. You are using this word, you like to get rest, but actually Mayadevi is going to take away this time period. But I'm not going to speak that you are never you like to take rest. Okay, your rest should be Hari Bhajan. Follow what I mean to say? You are going to rest, but that resting should be Hari Bhajan. In dream you can speak Krishna, Guru Vaishnava, hearing Harikatha. This way you will have to think all the time. Your sleeping also Hari Bhajan, others not. Then Mayadevi always searching some pinhole, you know? Mayadevi always searching some pinhole through which Mayadevi can enter your heart. And Koli is also Koli club. Koli always making one nice club, Saturday club and Sunday club. They are inviting, come, I can give you some facility all the time. So this way we are going to die. So in bhajan life, what is the mystery of bhajan? That we cannot allow even fraction of second to Mayadevi. We are not going to give any scope to Kali to enter into her, to make, you know, problem. This way we'll have to maintain our bhajan. Anyway, so I started with the sloka, you can remember. Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Balo Yopi Jadano Gruhat Tarenna Namato Graham Vyapto Siddhanta Sagaram. This sloka is where from? It's from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande, I am going to pray Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the lotus feet of Nityananda. By the mercy of Nityananda and Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I can cross away the all fighting in this Siddhanta field. All over the world, fighting going on. This Pandit speaking, no, you are wrong. He's speaking, oh, you are wrong. We are not going to fight. We are only going to take shelter of Nityananda Gaur. Because I get some commitment from on behalf of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. He is writing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Balo Pijadano Grahat, only one boy like Achyutananda. Achyutananda 4 or 5 years. Very small boy. You can take in lap and kiss. That Achyutananda also can speak big Siddhanta. Achyutananda can speak Bhagavatam. I cannot speak Bhagavatam because I am not Bhagavat. So if I can become Bhakta Bhagavat, then I can speak Bhagavatam. Achyutananda can speak Siddhanta to Advaita Gosai. What you are speaking? Eh? You are actually Jagat Guru Nityananda. You are speaking Guru of Nityananda, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Eh? You are going to ruin the whole world, Father. Advaita Gosai laughing, taking in love and kissing. Right you are actually. Oh my Father, you are. So this way, not a matter of joke, even small girl like Narayani, small girl, small boy, they can also speak volumes of Siddhanta. Kavi Karnapur, when Kavi Karnapur was very small, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to put his the main finger of right hand leg in his mouth. From then, Kavi Karnapur, of course, eternal parsad, Kavi Karnapur started writing so many things in small boy. Oh, very nice Siddhanta. And that Kavi Karnapur becomes so great Kavi that you cannot compare his writing on anybody. Ananda Gopal Champua, so many things I don't like to explain. So nice thing. Ananda Gopal Champua actually written by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. Madhava Utswap written by Jiva Goswami Pad. So rare books actually. And Kavi Karanapur also writing big books. Says, say Krishna Chaitanya, I think, big books. I have in my soft copy. Details discussion. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami. Full discussion. With the mercy of, you know, Raghunath Das Goswami, Murari Gupta, all. Oh, what all we are not getting in Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami's writing? Oh, full discussion we can get. Big volumes of, like dictionary. So, Kavi Karnapur actually writing stotra also so many. You can go through. Anyway, so Krishna, actually Kavi Karnapur when become great, you know, expressing. Kavi Karnapur also, Gaur Ganadas Deepika, who writing? Kavi Karnapur. Gaur Ganadas Deepika also written by Kavi Karnapur. That Gaur Ganadas Deepika, how he written? Fancifully? No. Gaur Ganadas Deepika, he was bound to write to locate who is who. In Gaur Lila this, Krishna Lila who, there is to give you some inspiration. Today actually is the Tirobhav Tithi, disappearance day of Devananda Pandit. I like to touch this point, it has some reason, vital point. Why? First of all, I like to explain that this Kavi Karnapur writing in, you know, Gaur Ganadas Deepika, that this Devananda Pandit is Bhagori Muni, Bhagori. Bhagori Muni in Krishna Lila. In Krishna Lila, Nanda Maharaja Sabha, assembly, every night. 6:30 or 7, oh, 1 hour, every day. Nanda Maharaja Sabha. Sabha, you know? Nanda Maharaja arranged all educated people, all kabi, all reciter, they are coming and they are expecting some donation from Raja, I mean Nanda Maharaj, they are giving huge donation to everybody, every day. So, they are actually, Bhagari Muni also are coming to give some advice to Nanda Maharaj. This way, we know from Kavi Karnapur, I mean the Gaur Ganadas Deepika, there is a Bhagari Muni. Now, why I am not going to avoid this topic, this has some reason. At the disappearance day coming or appearance day of Keshav Goswami Maharaj? Forget. Anyway, I forget. So that day I can discuss why Param Pujya Keshav Goswami Maharaj going to keep this name, Devananda Gaudiya Math, why? Has some secret reason. So today I can touch simply, not going to explain because my topics is totally different today. So I am making background actually. First of all, you know, if we can remember the topics of Devananda Pandit, then we can always remember the offense committed by him. If we can remember his name, Devananda, always remember, he committed aparadh knowingly or unknowingly. Knowingly or unknowingly, if you are going to do some aparadh, you cannot get respite. Knowingly or unknowingly, anyway, if you going to get some aparadh, you have to suffer. So, Devananda Pandit was not directly involved in this aparadh, not directly involved, but still, it was aparadh. Why? He was the leader there. At that time, there was nobody. Nobody was there who can explain Bhagavatam like Devananda Pandit. But still, he is not having pure devotion inside heart. Gyan. He is having jnana. So, jnana actually, he is having jnana. So, actually no devotion. No devotion. Pure devotion is not there. Bhakti is not there. So if bhakti is not there, Anyway, if you depend upon jnana, then you are going to be cheated. Because jnana cannot give you success in your life. Jnana cannot give you success in your life, ultimately. Anyway, in Chaitanya Charitamrita is the topmost book, even more than Srimad Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Charitamrita is such a book which I am bound to speak, which is, though Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavat equal to Bhagavatam. But still I would say this way, out of love, that it is more than Bhagavatam. Because in Chaitanya Charitamrita and Chaitanya Bhagavat, we can get accurate Siddhanta. If in my whole life, if I get the scope to explain Chaitanya Bhagavat, I would think that it is the mercy of Krishna. Because life is very short, I am taking preparation to leave body. When I can go, who can say? So anyway, if we can have the chance to explain, then you can understand why Maharaj is speaking this way. It is not Siddhanta Virodh. Because from Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can get fine Siddhanta. In Bhagavad also going to give sense, but you will have to play your head. You cannot directly understand. Anyway, you have to depend on Guru Vaishnava, but more catchy way, no? More acceptable. Bhagavatam, you can get some complacency, you cannot understand. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find some, facility. But still you will have to approach Guru Vaishnava, the source of transcendental sound vibration, source from which you can get exact explanation. Otherwise, you are not going to understand properly. There was a big fighting with Madhava Goswami Maharaj and one big pandit, Tarko Pancho Tarko Ratno, there. West Shyamnagar. After Barakpur, Palta, there Shyamnagar one place. There he went to meet him for some reason. He is fighting with Madhava Goswami Maharaj. At that time, Madhava Goswami Maharaj was, Vaigir Brahmachari or I forget. Anyway, that Pandit wanted to explain in front of Madhava Goswami Maharaj that Chaitanya Charitamrita is very easy, it's very easy. Because in Poyar, poetry, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavad. Madhava Goswami Maharaj was very angry that time inside. Wanted to prove that maybe you are, erudite scholar, maybe you know everything. But you cannot prove that you know Chaitanya Charitamrita. I can put some question, you give answer. This way. So, but still, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, we are going to get nice Siddhanta. What Siddhanta? That Gyan karma cannot give result without the mercy of Bhakti Devi. At all you are going to get some success in Gyan, in the path of Jnana. You are practicing Jnana. Suppose you are practicing karma arpan or karma yoga, a Gyan yoga. But they cannot give results separately without the mercy of Bhakti Devi. If at all you are going to get some success in Jnana Marg, but be sure maybe some bhakti was mixed. Like you are making one solution, sarbat, or you are going to take tea or milk, you add some sugar. Sugar, no? Nice sugar, you are going to add some sugar so that you can feel nice, tasty sugar. That way, actually, jnana karma, if not mixed with little bit bhakti, then ultimately you are not going to get success. Without, if it is totally devoid of bhakti, you are doing, jnana marg, then you cannot get success. Follow? Gyan karma also going to give you some success in that respective line, but without the mercy of Bhakti Devi, nobody can come out successful. This is already proved many times, thousands of crores of time, and not only that, in Srimad Bhagavatam also, In Bhagavatam also, glorification of Bhagavatam you can find. There also Bhakti Devi crying for Gyan Vairagya, two sons. Ultimately it was proved when Bhagavat Katha going on, all Sadhu Guru Vaishnava doing Kirtha. Sri Krishna Govinda Hare Murare He Nathana. When going Kirtan, then Supreme Lord appear there dancing, you know. Prahlad playing some instrument, and Indra Maharaj in a Mridanga, Arjun Kartal, everybody coming here. Narad Bina, you know. So nice. It was proved. So it is not in a false philosophy, 100%. Anyway, now actually Devananda Pandit was unparalleled, unbeaten that time. So, knowing Bhagavatam, not knowing actually from heart, but he is having that kind of power to recite Bhagavatam, that time unparalleled. Nobody was there in Navadvip or anywhere. But he was always doing some Gyanpar Bhakti. Gyanpar Mani, he is doing, explaining all sloka on the basis of Jnana, not going to explain Bhakti properly. Though Bhagavatam is full of Bhakti, full of Bhakti. Bhagavat is full of Bhakti, so nectar that Shankaracharya was bound to avoid Srimad Bhagavatam purposely. If Shankaracharya going to take help of Bhagavatam to establish Mayabad, Shankaracharya cannot come out successful. Shankaracharya, that's why wanted to avoid Bhagavatam. Because Bhagavatam is just equal to Krishna himself. Bhagavatam and Krishna all the same. Who is Bhagavatam? It's Krishna. That's why Shankaracharya was very clever to avoid that thing. So, you see, Shankaracharya wanted to avoid this Bhagavatam. So, Bhagavatam is full of rasa tattva, but Devananda Pandit is explaining Bhagavatam, not going to explain bhakti proper way. One day, our Sivas Pandit went there to attain the Bhagavad Katha. Let me see what kind of Bhagavad Katha going on. Sivas Pandit was sitting in the audience, hearing Bhagavad Katha there. And in the meantime, some sloka coming. Sivas Pandit couldn't bear. He bursted into tears and started crying, rolling down on ground. And that was unbearable for those material students. The students sitting here now to take lesson from Devananda Pandit. So they are there. They thought it's so disturbance you are making. And they carry whom? Sivas Pandit. And throw outside, throw in, put outside this hall where the discussion going. That was great offense on the part of those students. Also on the part of those, on the part of Devananda Pandit, because you are in Vyasasan, in temple, if any dangerous thing happening, Gurudev is responsible. Follow? Gurudev have to be here. We have seen your own life. How Guru Maharaj crying day and night. Some idiot making mistake. Giriraj burning in Calcutta temple. Guru Maharaj here burning. Oh, after some time, news came, you speak, Samal Krishna, you speak to Guru Maharaj that this devotee, nonsense, he is, you know, due to some reason, he couldn't maintain, you know, this kind of caution. He was unconscious, and that candle fall down on cloth and burn. Guru Maharaj burning from 1 hour, 2 hours already. Then after 2 hours news came. Guru Maharaj started crying, avoiding prasadam, water, everything for 3 days. Take away prasadam. I don't like to take, I can pay dandavattu prasadam. Giriraj Maharaj is equal to Krishna. You are going to burn. This way you are doing seva. Someday Gadadhar Pandit was just, Gaur Gadadhar Vigra there in our temple. Pujari is so idiot, so foolish. He wanted to change the clothes of Gadadhar. Somehow, Gadadhar was tilted this way. Vigraha. And by chance he was not going to fall down, he catch with his elbow to stop falling. Then Guru Maharaj in a room crying. After Archan is over, you call this devotee. Devotee crying? You are serving my Gaur and Gadada this way? Eh? You are giving pain? He want to avoid. Speak out what you have done inside temple. No, actually not. Speak. Don't try to pass away. Then he was bound to speak clearly. Gadadhar Pandit was going to fall down. I was bound to catch with elbow. Oh my God. Gadadhar already speaking to Guru Maharaj. Your sevak serving me this way. So this way, Gurudev is responsible. Spiritual leader. Spiritual leader is responsible for any nonsense, anything happening in a temple. A king of a country is responsible for any sinful activities going on in his country. Because he will have to anyway take one-sixth part, one whole amount of, you know, sinful activities incurred by different, you know, people staying in your country. Each countryman making any, you know, sinful activity, king will have to bear one-sixth part is actual scriptural analysis. Any wife doing all nonsense, husband will have to bear something. Be careful. Any small boy, teenage boy, I mean very small boy doing anything, father and mother will have to take. I have to. Be careful. So, don't try to become guru. Follow? There it is written, a king, Ramanuja is putting question, one by one. Can you prove that king can never be pious? Huh? Our king is pious? No. King is never pious, because he will have, though personally is pious, he will have to take 1/6 part of any sinful activities done. Follow? Why that, you know, that Kuloshekhar, the South Indian king, he was most pious. So pious you cannot imagine. But still he was bound to throw everything and come away pop to throw himself in pure devotion. Because he know I cannot maintain myself. Yudhishthir Maharaj, he was also anxious about his, you know, praja. When Yudhishthira started watching, oh, someday before they are not acting this way, their behavior, their activity is going to prove that now Kali is going to touch. Really so? Some period ago, Yudhishthira watching, they are so nice. At least they are maintaining something. Then when Yudhishthira started watching, is why they do? Oh, maybe Kali touching now. They're never going to do that way. They're never going to speak that way. Now they are speaking. That means Kali going to touch this world. Yudhishthira Maharaj could realize. So no king in this world can become pious. Of course, he is a devotee like Yudhishthira Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, out of his own bhajan can burn up those sinful activities they are doing. Follow? Out of his own bhajan power. So, Guru Padma Bhakti Pumat Purigishima is same. He is burning all papa, aparadh, out of his bhajan. We have seen. Feel from heart how he was controlling. Though he is sitting in bed, doing next to nothing. But those who are foolish, they are speaking this way. He is doing all things. Srila Sai Maharaj, all doing by all. He know that they cannot maintain purity. Sai Maharaj very clever, you know. So, our Guru Varga, we are lucky, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, in our life we have the chance to discuss their life history as the main thing, you see. Because If you go on reciting Bhagavatam, if you go on reciting Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, still you are not going to get the result you want to get. Maybe you cannot get. That's why very often I speak this sloka, na? Sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanyasa surir virita artha tattad gunanu sabanam mukunda padaravinda hidesh yesham. You can go on reciting Bhagavad Gita. Okay, it's not bad. But you are not going to fulfill your target of in devotional field. If you go on discussing the life history of Guru Vaishnava, try to hear clearly today. This is the key, you see. Though I know you are quick, but still you can get power. That is the key. So you will have to discuss the life history of Guru Vaishnava. Then automatically Krishna bound to give you kippa. Krishna bound to give you kippa. So you have to discuss all the life history, all the, you know, ontological aspect and morphological aspect, both. Because though morphological aspect I am speaking, but still it is not actually morphology. Guru Vaishnava body and everything is transcendental. Anyway, but we are in favor of Prabhupada. All the time, we are in favor of Keshav Goswami Maharaj. Anytime anybody giving order me to speak something about Guru Vaishnava, I always try to touch the Bani Swarup of that Vaishnava. That day when I speak Harikatha in Devananda Gauri Mat, that day I complete my Harikatha here, 8 o'clock night. When I go back, then also from Kumargam is the border place of Assam and Sikkim. I've been there. They requesting me, oh, and now also they are requesting one time long ago. Now from there, one devotee of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, they are opening one big school, and not school actually, they are actually at present they are arranging one function. Actually, it's big function of Harikatha. I am here, they ring me, but I don't touch. But when I go back, then again they wanted to hear some Katha over telephone about Bhaman Maharaj. So I started speaking about Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, I mean Harikatha. At least half an hour or 35 minutes I speak. And then they are giving dandavat to me. Maharaj, you know, here at least 100 people hearing your Harikatha. How? This telephone, they mouthpiece, they touch with one, they fit with one. Loudspeaker, there are at least 800 people they are hearing at present your Harikatha. I mean, really? Okay, they know hearing Harikatha. So within that short period also, I wanted to touch the Bani Swarup of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. That is my target. I learned it from Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, or to touch Bani Swarup, because it's the actual benefit you can get. Because if you cannot understand the Bani Swarup of Guru Vaishnava, if you can go on hearing something about his life, okay, still good. But if you want to get 100% success, you have to discuss all about Bani Swarup. Anyway, so actually, that is the point actually, that Pandit fighting. So Chaitanya Bhagavata Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Chaitanya Bhagavata Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can get scope. To get fine is the more easiest way, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavat, you know. So this way, actually, we are going to discuss this point, what I was just discussing just before. Srivas Thakur was there, that time he was committing aparadh because he was the leader. Follow? Srivas Thakur, they put him outside. That was great offense. From then, Devananda Pandit can realize that I am doing some offense after that. So, but someday, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving in scope to serve Bhakeshwar Pandit. Someday, Bhakeshwar Pandit came here in Navadvip Dham. Bhakeshwar Pandit originally from Orissa. Puri district, you know, Bhakesha Pandit, you know, Gopal Guru Goswami, you know, Gambira, that is their sipat. Bhakesha Pandit got the chance because Bhakesha Pandit dancing continuously 48 hours, 72 hours continuously, non-stop dancing. Inconceivable, you cannot believe. Is written continuously dancing 48 hours, 30 hours, continuously, you know, as if consciousness gone, he is in samadhi, but dancing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so happy with Bhakesha Pandit. Oh, powerful. Then this, you know, Devananda Pandit, he got the chance to serve whom? Bhakesha Pandit. Oh, crowded place. Bhakesha Pandit dancing and he wanted to protect the barricade. Hey, don't come. And not only that, he wanted to make chamar bhajan or, you know, fan, hand fan, moving. Sweat coming, na? So this way, Devananda Pandit got the chance to serve Bhakesha Pandit. This way, Sriman Mahaprabhu become very happy. One day when Gauranga Mahaprabhu passed crossing this river Ganga and going, passing that way, when Devananda Pandit expressing Bhagavatam, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu golden complex become, hey, you have no right to read Bhagavatam. Ebetar Bhagavate kon adhikar, in Bengali speaking. Ebetar Bhagavate kon adhikar. Then Mahaprabhu giving advice to follow Guru Vaishnava. You can also remember when Ballabhatta wanted to insult Siddha Sai Pad, then Mahaprabhu become lion. You are like pros. You don't like to obey husband. I mean, Swami nahi mano. Eh? Siddha Sai Pad by the mercy of Nishingadev. How Siddha Sai Pad knowing all the, you know, all detailed explanation of Bhagavatam? Bhagavatam is Krishna himself by the mercy of Nishingadev. Nishingadev blessing. So Siddharam Betti Nishinga Pashadat. Siddharam Betti Nishinga Pashadat by the mercy of Nishingadev. Siddha Sai Pad can know all, everything. So you are going to insult? You don't like to accept the explanation, commentary of Siddha. You have that kind of audacity. After that, he was fearing. Someday after, Mahaprabhu also, when become happy, then speaking, don't try to express that kind of mood. If you are at all going to write commentary, well, you can do. But under the guidance of Siddha Sai Pad, don't try to disobey him, don't try to insult him. Great offense. So this way we can go offense anytime in your life if you are not careful to avoid offense all the time. Maybe you are doing less bhajan, okay? But don't try to commit any offense. Be careful. Try to bear everything. Go on increasing your enduring power, bearing power, so that sahan silata, you know, in Bengali, sahan silata. Sahan means bearing. Power, you have to increase. Otherwise, you can never become pure Vaishnavi or Vaishnava. So this way, actually, Mahaprabhu giving in teachings. So you will have to take lesson. You will have to take lesson from this incident. What incident? What incident? That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving. Lesson 2, Devananda Pandit, that we can remember whole life so that we are not going to make any aparadh. That lesson we get from this Leela, and not only that, actually, this Keshav Goswami Maharaj, why giving this name Devananda Pandit? Why? Devananda Pandit, Devananda Gauriya, I can remember. Devananda Pandit must be very careful about the offense. That's why Keshav Goswami Maharaj, we find more wanted to represent this name, nice. So anyway, so this way, Devananda Pandit got the scope. Someday he was doing seva of Bhakrasa Pandit. Mahaprabhu become very happy. Then he become full of devotion. Otherwise, devotion is not a matter of joke. So this way, I was bound to touch this Siddhanta, everything. At the same time, I was bound to speak something about Devananda Pandit, all the secrecy there in Siddhanta. Now I want to touch the main thing. Why I started with this point? That only one small boy can also speak Siddhanta, proper Siddhanta, if they are going to get the full mercy of Nityananda and Gauranga. If you have the scope to get the mercy of Nityananda, then you can go on speaking like wind, Harikatha, Siddhanta writing, Anantadev. Now why I touch? Now I can explain this point, why I am starting this point. Because first of all, you can remember that compromise is not at all allowed in the way of your devotion. And from Mahabharata, we learn this thing, Mahayano yeno gato sapantha. You learn, na? Mahayano, those Mahayan, running this track, I will have to go this same track. I cannot break. That's why I told, na, that in the beginning, the slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Patmadma can ultimately throw you away from bhajan track, bhajan field. So now I want to touch this point. For a long time, some contradiction going on, big fighting going on all over the world on some issue of Jivatma and their Nitya Saru, everything. So you can remember, maybe 8 months or 9 months, or I forget. Ago, I was discussing someday. That was also Ekadashi day, I think. But that was also not complete. So today I like to explain. So many writings I write already, due to lack of time, I couldn't complete it. Typing and everything not complete. And that's why I like to discuss this point, touch this point. But I am not going to fight with any party, so I can put both party. I mean, one party, one group speaking, that jives swarup hoy Krishna nitya das, okay. From this I can show jives swarup, how in tatastha condition, where staying, where from jiva came, what result they can meet in future. All I can discuss. So I promise you, you can remember, on December I can touch. I am very sorry, December already going to be finished, but still I can fulfill my commitment. As December already, December going on. So December I told you touch, I can touch, today I touch. The first part of my speech, it is have some relevancy. Not that it has no link. First part, I am discussing about Devananda Pandit, but still have some link with this part. So, aparadh we don't like to do. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, what Jiva Goswami Pad speaking, what Baladev Vidyabhusan speaking, what Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, all we like to, you know, search and show you what is exact Siddhanta. But first of all, when one group fighting, there is in this world two groups. One Vaishnava, in this Gauriya Vaishnava, there are two groups. One group going to speak that Sarup of Jiva is not fixed. Another group, they are speaking the Sarup of Jiva is always fixed. Then what to do? First of all, I am going to explain that Jiva Sarup is not fixed. I am not going to put myself in any party color. Always you be sure that I am always in favor of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Guru Varga. So I write myself this book, but I forget. This book was edited by me. It was published from Chaitanya Gaurimath. It's Bhagavad Sakatkar. I write myself. But long ago, but due to this fighting, he is speaking. I was thinking what to do. So now I am going to speak on behalf of both party. One group speaking that the swarup of jiva is not fixed, and another guru speaking that swarup of jiva is fixed. So in what party I am in favor of Jiva Goswami Pad, I am in favor of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I am in favor of all Guru Varga. But still, now, as a, from neutral point, I am going to discuss. Ultimately, finally, I can identify myself in which group I am from. First group, actually, they are going to speak that Jiva Sarup is not at all fixed. Not at all fixed. Now, first point, who is Jiva? First of all, you will have to learn, know it first. That actually, Jiva emanating from Tatastha Shakti of Krishna. Jiva, all Jiva, countless Jiva, they are emanating from Tatastha Shakti of Krishna. Tatastha Shakti of Krishna. Now, Tatastha Shakti has no place in Sarup Shakti. Try to understand. Jiva Shakti, Maya Shakti, or Chit Shakti, Jiva Shakti, or Maya Shakti. Pure Chit Shakti means purity. Chit Shakti always means Sarup Shakti from inside. But Jiva Shakti has no place inside Sarup Shakti. That's why simultaneously Jiva Shakti is inside Krishna, but still not inside Krishna. With Krishna and not without Krishna, both. I can prove it day by day. It will take maybe 2-3 months. I can go on discussing this point. Jiva Shakti actually from Krishna, no doubt. But still, Jiva Shakti has no place, not going to enjoy the power, kripa of Sarup Shakti. Sarup Shakti resting inside Krishna. Without the mercy of Sarup Shakti, no jiva can get bhakti. Follow? But last speech, maybe 9 months before, I told there is no smell of bhakti with jiva. I cannot believe. Why I told? That also first I like to substantiate. I like to prove this point. Though direct Sarup Shakti is not there, still I was bound to prove that day that no smell of bhakti is there in jiva. I cannot believe you. I told it. Now today I like to prove it. Why? Actually, point is that internal potency is staying with Krishna, okay. But everything in the world, and what about jiva shakti? Jiva Shakti, Tatastha Shakti also simultaneously with Krishna and without Krishna. Now, point is that Krishna Achinta Vedavet Tattva, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove. Now, directly or indirectly, everything coming from Krishna. Right, Yuva? This point first, like mathematics. Directly or indirectly, everything coming from Krishna. There is no fighting on this point. Yasai kanisheshito kalam athavalambo jivanti loma bilaja jagadandanatha vishnura mahanasa iho yasu kalavishesho gavinda madhi purusham tamaham bhajami. All source coming from Krishna. Though in this loka speaking from Mahavishnu, infinity, in this, you know, tip of here, one tip of here, and a body, in one tip, there is infinity Brahmanda. Now you can, inconceivable, who is Mahavishnu. And after that you will have to calculate, this Mahavishnu coming from Krishna. You can go mad, faint. Oh my God, it's impossible, I cannot. Now my point is that, I don't like to discuss all this point. I can discuss next day, maybe for 3-4 months. First point, Krishna having bhakti or not? Krishna having bhakti? Arey Maharaj, bhakti is the matter with jiva. Huh? And jiva also, there is different kind of explanation there. One is sangsha, one is vibhinnangsha. Sangsha, I can explain next day because today I cannot get time. Who is sangsha? What do you mean by sangsha? What do you mean by vivinna angsa? All I can discuss scientifically. I'm not going to avoid any point. So now, this, you know, Krishna having bhakti or not, that is my first question to you. If Krishna not having bhakti, what is not there in Krishna, that is not there in Jiva. I already told, na, if I am going to churn water, I can get cream? No possibility, no potency is there. But if I am going to churn milk or, you know, curd, then I can get some yogurt and get some cream out of that, right? Because already potency is there inside milk or curd to get cream. If you go on churning milk, you cannot get. So, jive swarup hai Krishna nitya das, but be careful, jive swarup hai Krishna nitya bhakto. This word is not used. Very scientific word. Das is also devotion means, but why the scientific word used? Why Krishnadas Goswami, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami not writing jive swarup hai Krishna nitya bhakto, not using this word? Jive swarup hai Krishna nitya das, not bhakto. Because bhakto means, if you are not going to start direct seva, then I cannot say that you are devotee. Follow my point. Why Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami using this scientific point? Maharaj, das means already devotion start. No, has some difference. Why jive swarup hai Krishna nitya das, this word used, not Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami not using this word, jive swarup hai Krishna nitya bhakta. And Santo Goswami Maharaj writing, jive swarup hai Guru nitya das. Is all or more precious, more accurate. Maya. Maya Devi. So you see, jive swarup hai Krishna nitya das, and jive swarup hai Krishna nitya bhakta. What is the difference? Suppose you are missing from your father. Follow one example I am giving. Go on speaking. Suppose you are missing from your father. Your father cannot trace you out for a long time. Maybe in childhood, the boy is missing. Follow. Boy is missing and boy speaking, my father is missing. Okay. That father speaking, boy is missing. It's right. But father and son, this relation is not missing. Follow my point, what I mean to say. Though father cannot trace out son, son cannot trace out father, it's okay. But father and son relation is not missing. It's there. Persisting inside your heart, inside the heart of that boy also, they cannot trace. So, point is that servant missing, not going to disturb Krishna. Krishna boli sei jivanadi vairmukh, but still, jiva is a servant of Krishna, that you cannot deny. He is not serving. That's why he is not bhakta. But servant, this title is also there. Follow, this title already there. He is servant, no other way. He cannot disprove it. He cannot prove that the jiva is not serving. Okay, but he is not serving. Krishna bully, he forget Krishna. He is, you know, serving Maya. So we cannot speak that he is devotee. But dasatta, this relation is there. That's why Krishnadas Bhagavad is so accurate. Jive swarup hai Krishna. This anyway, you confess or not going to confess, you are going to fight, you are going to give slogan. Okay, I cannot believe that Krishna is. But still, knowingly or unknowingly, you will have to believe. You will have to confess that there is no. Even Jesus Christ is also servant of Krishna. Jesus Christ himself told, I read Bible when I was a small boy. I read Bible, you put question, I can give answer. You cannot give answer. You read Bible, no? I can put answer. You cannot answer. Now I can put question. Follow, you see. So you see, Jesus Christ told, I am the servant I am the son of that Supreme Lord. He never told, I am Supreme Lord. Jesus Christ always told, I am coming from Him. I am the messenger. Hello, Paigambar also in Muslim, he also messenger. But they are explaining wrong way. Follow what I say? Now point is that if I put one question from Bible, can you give answer? You have your power? In Bible it is written, Mama, very careful. In Bible it is written that, what is written? That all those who are going to commit some papa, they are going to be sent to hell forever. And those who are going to pious activities, they are going to go to heaven forever. I put question in front of Christian missionary. They come to beg for me. I give some donation in my previous life. I was young that time. I have one question. I go through Bible that I cannot believe. What? But actually, Supreme Lord is very merciful. Yes. Supreme Lord cannot have that kind of mentality that my mother used to beat me in my childhood. But not that always she can beat me. Sometimes she can kiss me also. There is a system. So Supreme Lord, for some wrong activities, sinful activities, cannot send His son, all Jivatma His son, to hell forever. And one son doing some pious activities, sending him to heaven forever. This kind of disparity cannot, he cannot answer. That Christian missionary cannot answer. Oh, real light cannot answer. It cannot so happen. So, Supreme Lord is more liberal. Supreme Lord can kiss you if you are doing some nice activities, bhakti, and when you are doing some wrong, going to hell for some certain period, not forever. Forever? No! Not forever. That's why Jamdut coming to give treatment. But after next life, he can also get the scope to get the mercy of Guru Vaishnava and start Bhajan. Who can say? It's not usual rule that father and mother can put son in hell forever and puts one nice son forever in heaven. This kind of disparity we cannot believe. Also, they are explaining wrong way, Old Testament and New Testament. Old Testament it is written, Jesus Christ never used to take meat, nothing. But New Testament they forcefully want to phago. Phago, this word they want to prove this is meat. But phago doesn't mean meat. Also Muslim Sampradaya, they want to prove. We can show it is written there, you want to say, take, you know, phago, who? Huh? Who? Huh? Allah no. Who? Preach. Muhammad. Muhammad. Muhammad, you should take butter, honey, bread, fruits, it is written there. They are explaining wrong way. So later on, they started explaining wrong way. Actually, it is not true. You go through Old Testament, very, very old. Testament, 3,000, 4,000 years back, not writing. They are trying to misguide people. So this way, now I am going to touch this one, main point actually. So I give two examples. So many examples I can put in front of you from Bible, from Quran. You cannot give answer. Guru Granth Sahib. Guru Granth Sahib, those are Punjabi people. Sikh. I can put some question, they cannot answer properly. So now point is that Jive Swarup Hoy Krishna Nitya Das is properly represented. Because if father is father and son gone from Ithaja, father cannot trace out son cannot trace, but still the relationship is there. Relationship is not going to be destroyed. Even my father gone long ago, but still, if I think about my previous life, I will have to think, okay, he was my previous father. Okay, I will have to speak. It is gratitude, I will have to speak. So this relation is not missing. Man missing, this missing. That's why Jive Swarup Hoy Krishna Nitya Das, Jive Swarup Hoy Krishna Nitya Bhakta, this is not speaking. Now second point I have, how I can say that Krishna have no devotion? What is not there in Krishna, you cannot expect. It is written there in Shastra, in Bhagavatam itself, I can prove. Why Krishna following devotees? Why Ramchandra following devotees? Why Gauranga Mahapo following devotees? Why Gauranga Mahapo serving Sivas Pandit Gadar? Why? Wet cloth from Ganga. Let me carry your bag. No, no, no. No, no, I like to carry. Gauranga Mahapo Nimai. Carrying the bag of fruits and flower and wet clothes. What does it mean? Supreme Lord surely having bhakti. But the mode of bhakti is little different. Jivas, they are going to serve Krishna. That's why this bhakti mode is little different. And Krishna want to serve devotees. This devotional mood is little different. Have some variety. But devotion is 100% there. Inside Krishna. Otherwise, why Krishna going to speak that I like to take the dust particle from the lotus feet of all devotees? Why Krishna speaking to Radharani, Saragarala Mandalam, Mamasirase Mandalam, Dehipada Pallava Mudarum, Ho Radharani, you please give your lotus feet on my head to quench my, you know, anxiety, to quench my, you know, restlessness. How possible? In front of Krishna, in front of Radharani, Krishna speaking. Saragarala Mandanam, Mamasirase Mandalam, Dehipada Pallava Mudarum, Ho Radharani, please excuse me. I have done some mistake. Give your lotus feet on my head so that I can quench myself. What does this mean? That Bhagavan is Bhakta Bhaktiman. Follow my point. Don't follow. Bengali not learning properly. Bhagavan Bhakta Bhaktiman. Devotees, they are Krishna Bhaktiman or Vishnu Bhaktiman. They are going to serve Krishna, devotees. Krishna want to serve all devotees. Otherwise, why Krishna speaking? Ye yathamang prapadante tangs tathima bhajami ham. Krishna speaking like? Krishna speaking in Gita. You never notice this sloka? Very simple thing, all the time we are speaking. Ye yathamam prapadante tang stathiva bhajami aham. Any devotee showing any kind of devotion, I am also going to say, reflect same devotion to him. Ye yathamam prapadante tang stathiva bhajami aham. I mean Krishna speaking from his lotus mouth that I have also devotion. I am serving. Bhajami aham mean bhajratu seva. So I already proved. Krishna having devotion. Krishna having devotion. So Jivatma, okay, they have no smell of devotion that I cannot speak. Smell, bhakti is not there. Smell is not there. How possible? If I put in any container, hingur, you know, hingur, and kampur in one pot, 2 years back I make it vacant, but still, if you tight it and open and find the smell of kampur and hingur, you cannot avoid it. Anyhow, so Jivatma, they are supposed to serve Krishna, they are not serving, okay. They are serving Maya, that is also a perverted reflection of that seva. They are supposed to serve Krishna, follow my point. They are supposed to serve Krishna. But that Krishna Seva took the form of reflected form and coming in the form of Maya Seva. They are supposed to serve Krishna. So Krishna having devotion for devotees. And devotees, they have devotion for Krishna. Follow? So those Jivatma, maybe at present they are doing Maya Seva, but potency is not at all there. Smell is not there, we cannot say. Nitya siddho Krishna prem sadhu kobu noy shobonaddi chitte hada koraya odai. I can explain day by day this all point. Scientifically, I want to explain. Now I prove the smell of bhakti is not there, potency not at all there in jiva to get bhakti. Yes, I cannot confess. Follow? Now I want to go back to another slok is from Bhagavatam. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that I am running in behind all devotees. Why? A question put by Uddhav. Uddhav saying, why Prabhu you are running behind devotees? Well, I have some reason, secret reason. What reason? Anubrajami aham puyeti angri renuvi. You know Sanskrit? No? Foolish. Anubrajami aham. I am running behind devotees. I am following all devotees. Because the devotees when running away, they are all in air. They are dust particle hovering here and there, moving in air. So I like to move. So that on my head, all their dust particle can come and make me pure. You are not pure? Well, no, I am not pure. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, Prabhu kahe tomar sporsi pavitra haite, tomar pavitra gun nahi ko amate. When all, you know, scabies, blood coming out of Sanatan, and you know, Sanatan, don't touch me, I can... Prabhu say, Prabhu, forcefully take an embrace, you know, and speaking, Prabhu speaking, you know, you have that kind of pure devotion, love for Krishna. Prabhu kahe, Prabhu saying, that kind of purity I don't have. That's why I like to embrace you, to get purity. See, this is the mood of Krishna. If you understand Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you cannot stay in room. You can become crazy, run. And try to sing the song. Kabe gauro bone surodhoni tate haradeha Krishna boli. You will have to sing. Like Bhaktivinoda Gaur, like crazy, running here and there. Try to watch, where is Gaur? Where is Nithananda? It is written that today also Gaur Nithananda doing Leela, but why I cannot see? Bhaktivinoda crying, like crazy. You cannot stay. So you are going to pay attention to small, small thing. You are going to miss the, you know, infinity love shown by Krishna. You are actually foolish. So this way we are going to lose everything. So now I prove that the Jivatma, they all have potency. Potential, but devotion, direct devotion, not possible. I can prove next day. Until and unless one jivatma going to enjoy the kripa of sarup shakti, cannot get devotion, amrita, bhakti. Maybe that kripa not coming directly from Radharani, but through devotees. Devotees mean Guru Vaishnava. That's why it is written, na? Brahmanda bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev Guru Krishna prasade pai. You learn this, no? Brahmanda bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev Guru Krishna prasade pai bhakti la. I can discuss next day. So without the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, we cannot get devotion. Sadhu sanga sarvasasthe koy labamatto sadhu sanga sarvasiddhi hoy. Krishna bhakti janma mool hai sadhu sanga, all I can prove. All going to meet this condition that you are going to, somehow you are going to get kripa from Guru Vaishnava or anyway. Without the kripa of sarup shakti, you cannot get bhakti. I can prove next day. Now point is that in Upanishad, they are reading Krishna speaking. Because there is nobody there. Before creation, when creation started, that I cannot speak. Creation is also nitya. Krishna is also nitya. Or jivatma nitya. Well, how then I can adjust this point? You cannot adjust. You can become crazy, mad. You cannot believe. At the same time, all true. Yes. When creation started, anadi. I cannot speak. When srishti started, this destruction and creation again started, again destruction. When started, I cannot speak. When Gaur was there, or Radha Govinda first, I cannot speak. Because in eternal world, all eternal. Though we see, Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasmat Ekatmanu Opi Dehovedam Gatau Tau, that I can speak. Because it is written. But in my conception, there should not be any limit conception. If there is any limited conception, limit of conception, then I am going to miss everything, vacant. So when creation started, follow what I say? Now point is that the jiva, anyway, I prove already, they are going to get kripa from Guru Vaishnava, not directly from Radharani. Because Radharani and Krishna all the same. Jai Radha, who is Radharani, who is Krishna? Sa evo sa, from Bhagavat Mahima, glorification. Sa evo sa, all same. Who is Radharani, who is Krishna? No difference. But Sarup Shakti always staying inside Krishna. We are saying, going to see the picture of Radharani. We think it's a separate picture, not the same. Now point is that Krishna speaking, Ekvaham Bahuswam in Upanishad. Ekvaham, I am one and single, unique Adyagantata. Right? In Bhagavatam? What is it in? Badanti tattattvavidam sattabhyadgan adyayam brahmeti bhagavaniti paramatmeti sabdati. All I am giving evidence. So, Tattva is one and single. It is your foolishness that you are thinking, I am one Mataji, he is one Pitaji. Tattva is one and single. If you can feel, then you can stop crying. Tattva is one and single, that is Krishna. But still, diversity in unity, unity in diversity. You have to feel. All infinity world, there is one and single Tattva, that is Adyagantata. Still, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Adyagantata, Ekoham Bahuswam. I am one and single. I cannot play. I will have to play with somebody. So, Ekoham Bahuswam. Bhagavan is one and single, Adyagantata. Still, is not this Adyagantata not going to be disturbed. At the same time, Krishna become infinity Jivatma, all creation, all. Diversity. Krishna is one? Yes. All trees and planets, man, woman, all Srishti creation? Yes. Follow my point? So if Adyagantata can exhibit that I am Adyagantata, still I can manifest myself in diversity, then why you are going to disbelieve that Krishna cannot express diversity regarding Jivatma? I can prove. Second point I can come. First, I am fighting now in favor of first party. So I should not speak that way. So first party who is speaking, Jivatma, they have no, you know, they are not specific sarup. Okay, I am fighting in favor, I am not pleader in favor of that party, I am fighting. Now, Jivatma is countless. Jivatma emanating, coming out. Go on. If one word missing, the meaning changing, foolish. So, Jivatma countless is a chit potency. Oh, infinity Jivatma coming, light, sun rays already spoken. All Tatasya Shakti took the form of all infinity Jivatma. Now, if it's coming from the sense source, of Krishna Surya, Krishna Sun. If I believe that from Krishna Sun it is written in Shastra, then how I can find diversity? If I think Krishna going to make Jivatma this Jivatma is wrong. He says there can be some party color. Krishna cannot have that kind of mood because Krishna is most neutral personality. Why Krishna going to make this Jivatma Santaras, why going to this? Oh, this cannot be so. I am fighting now in favor of first party. Okay, I am pleader now. In front of my Lord, you know, Nityananda I am speaking. In front of my Lord, Nityananda I am speaking. So it cannot so happen. It's all wrong. Eh? All Jivatma coming, okay. Jivatma has some potency, okay, chit. But chit, all same quality should be there. It is expected. All same quality coming off. Why Krishna make diversity? All same ray coming. Oh, it cannot be so. I cannot believe that there can be any diversity Because all chit potency, all same. Oh, really, Maharaj, I cannot believe that Krishna going to make any diversity. I cannot believe. So we can fight in favor of first party. Jivatma, all, they cannot have separate sorrow. It's not possible. Okay? Because all come Chidatma, and in Gita also speaking, Balagru Bhagasya, Satabhagasya, Satadha Kalpitasacha. It's all written same for all Jivatma. Really so? But there is no diversity written here. It's really so? So, actually, there cannot be any diversity. All Jivatma, all same. All chit potency is coming. How we can expect different kind of, you know, coming from? No, not possible. At first point, Krishna cannot have that kind of particular or that kind of partiality so that Krishna can give one Jivatma, one rasa, another one. Oh, it cannot be so. So we cannot believe. So all Jivatma, different Jivatma, same. So they can go on doing bhajan. Someday they can come in contact of Guru Vaishnava. They can change their mood. They can start Hari Bhajan through Guru Padma, by the mercy of Guru Padma, they can take shelter, go on doing seva. Brahmando bhamite kono bhagavan jeev, Guru Krishna prasade phai bhakti. So according to the Guru, he is going to accept. Same Guru also sometimes giving different rasa, because this Guru, this Shishya is not matured. It can also so happen in Jaiva Dharma we get. So, anyway, they are going to get some rasa bhava anyway. First of all, they can get stability. I am not going to speak like sahajya. Oh, jivatma kind, they can start ekdam gopi bhava. Not, it's totally against. Jivatma, they have no stability. First of all, I can push you. I can beat you. I can throw you out. Let me see, you have that kind of patience, believe and love for me. I can start beating you. Let me test you, you know. In Upanishad, Upamanyu was thrown, go! But still Upamanyu is not going to leave trust on Gurudev. 100% believe. Not only that, when Upamanyu getting all knowledge from forest, but still when come back to Gurudev, Gurudev said, now your appearance looking that you are already getting a tathagyan. Okay, Gurudev, don't speak that way. Though I am getting that, but still it is not practical. What do you mean? Gurudev, I like to hear all tathagyan from you again. Because if I am not going to hear from Guru Vaishnav, it's not good. It's not come to my realization. So Upamanyu started hearing all tatha from Gurudev. Then practicality came. Follow? So I can learn, I can buy so many books, rasa tatha books, ujjal nimitis dek. You have your mind in your pocket and go and buy. But where from you get realization that you can get? You can become gopi without the help of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada? Guru, no. Not that. That's why you must be very careful. So, Brahmando Brahmita Guna Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Pusade Bhai Bhakti Ladabhai. This means, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, you can get some solution in your life. Because one log, wooden log, floating in sea for a long time, but not getting any end, you know? Shore, you know? Seashore, not getting. Shore mean end. Not getting. Is it in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Brahmanda Bhamite Kono Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai, Bhakti Lathavich. This way, Jivatma floating for a long time, like log, water, by wooden log. By the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, now they get the mercy of Guru Vaishnav, they look at Guru Vaishnav and find power. Just looking like so powerful. I told already Bhakti Pradip Tithu Maharaj, when look at Prabhupada in Jogpit, like hundreds of, you know, sun, so power, glamour, devotion. He could realize some consolation must be there in his lotus feet. I can get. He is a source of Prakita Sabda Brahma. Then in the evening time came and took shelter. Oh, you save me, please. This way, Guru Vaishnava has unknown power. You cannot see, you are blind. You always try to insult Guru Vaishnava. You like to throw away Guru. Go, 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 go. You need not speak. This way they always want to insult Guru Vaishnava and going to go down and down and down in hell. Degradation of humanity is not, you know, it's really painful. Degradation of humanity, what to speak about devotional life? They are not having humanity. Inhuman activities they are showing in the apron of devotion. Sannyasi and Brahmacharya, I am bound to speak in Vyasasan. What to speak? Inhuman activities they are showing. So degradation of humanity mean at least you should have humanity. At least you should have that kind of qualities which we can expect from an ideal man. Ideality also, I can speak Vaishnava, without Vaishnava no ideality we can get. But in material sense also. So now actually, one party is speaking, according to association, they are growing their mood, ultimately they are going to get their specific identity in spiritual sky. Follow my point? This is one group. I can discuss in more details about this group also. After that, time can permit me when I can start argument about that second party. And ultimately, you know, from which party I am, I can identify myself after that. Okay? So, Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Bala Yopi Jadano Gruha Tarena Namato Grahyam Vyaptam Siddhanta Sagaram Vancha Kalpudurvasya Kepasinda Bhavicha Patitanam Pavana Bhavishna Pyo Namona. So all my papers are in raw form, you see, for long time. I cannot complete because no time. He is pulling me there, he is pulling me there, he is pulling me. Where to go? Follow. Any question you have up to this point? Up to this point, what question you have? Any effective question? What question you have?
You mentioned jivas is not
Mercy of swarup, without the mercy of swarup shakti, no jiva can attain bhakti. But potency must be there. Potency and smell may be there, but bhakti not getting practically. Follow? Only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, Guru and mercy, if they find that you are really a niskapat, if any kapat bhav is there, Guru Vaishnava going to ignore you. Follow? If Guru Vaishnava going to accept you as disciple, follow my point, vital point, I can explain next day. If my Gurudev, I am in Vyasasan, if my Gurudev at all going to accept me, the Sam Baba is my disciple, at all then I can get kippa. If Guru Maharaj discovered that I have some hypocrisy, I like to get some money, position, so many, pratishtha, then Guru Maharaj is going to ignore me. Useless. Externally, I can only identify that I am the disciple of Bhakti Bhavan Purgishti Maharaj, but I have no right to identify that way, because I am kapat. Follow? All different examples, mathematical, I can prove next day. Follow? So, today I am going to...